Good afternoon. And welcome to the celebration of the Mass for the 11th Sunday in Ordinary Time. At this time, we ask that you please turn off all cell phones and electronic devices. As a Eucharistic-centered community, all of our actions flow out of our love for the sacrament. Out of reverence for the Eucharist and out of respect for each other, we kindly ask that you remain in the pew until the Mass is completed and the celebrant has processed out of the church. The scripture readings for today's Mass can be found on page 177 in the hymnal. The order of the Mass with the congregation's responses can be found on your pew card or on page 3. Our opening hymn can be found at number 515, We Walk by Faith, number 515. Our priest celebrant today is Father Rocky. Will you please stand and join in our opening hymn?
Good afternoon, everyone. We are celebrating this Mass for Thaddeus M. Weber. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. As we stand in the house of God, let us take time to examine our conscience and pray for God's mercy to heal us from our sins. You bring light to those who are in darkness, Lord, have mercy. You forgive us our sins, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You raise us to new life, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. O God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas. And since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord God, I too will take from the crest of the cedar, from its topmost branches tear off a tender shoot and plant it on a high and lofty mountain. On the mountain heights of Israel I will plant it. It shall put forth branches and bear fruit and become a majestic cedar. Birds of every kind shall dwell beneath it, every winged thing in the shade of its boughs. And all the trees of the field shall know that I, the Lord, bring low the high tree, lift high the lowly tree, wither up the green tree, and make the withered tree bloom. As I, the Lord, have spoken, so will I do. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord, for we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus said to the crowds, "This is how it is with the kingdom of God. It is as if a man were to scatter seed on the land and would sleep and rise night and day, and through it all the seed would sprout and grow. He knows not how. Of its own accord, the land yields fruit, first the blade, then the ear, then the full grain in the ear. And then the grain is ripe. He wields the sickle at once, for the harvest has come." Then Jesus said, "To what shall we compare the kingdom of God, or what parable can we use for it? It is like a mustard seed that when it is sown in the ground is the smallest of all the seeds on the earth. But once it is sown, it springs up and becomes the largest of plants and puts forth large branches so that the birds of the sky can dwell in its shade." With many such parables, Jesus spoke the word to them as they were able to understand it. Without parables, he did not speak to them, but to his own disciples, he explained everything in private. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
This weekend, we are celebrating Father's Day, right? Am I on the right date here? I sure hope so, because my whole homily is centered on Father's Day. And so today, Father's Day, tomorrow, is a reminder for all of us, that even with all the changes that have happened in society in our modern day world, the Father remains an essential figure in the Christian family, meaning that the ideal Christian family is that of a father, a mother, and a child, or children. Not just a mother and children. Many people ask, who needs fathers nowadays? You know, because women can go to a fertility clinic and have their own kids without the father. Who needs father these days? The children do. And this is often forgotten. by many adults, especially when the trouble comes to a couple and they start discussing divorce. They tend to look only at the interest of the man and the woman. But in their anger, they tend to forget that divorce is often not only affecting the man and the woman, it's also affecting the child or the children. Every child has a God-given right to have a mother and a father. Therefore, we need to protect that right of the children. A father's love is different than a mother's love. And children need both, just like our bodies need both proteins and carbohydrates in order to have a balanced health. Kids need their fathers as role models just as much as they need the mothers as role models. I have a father and a mother, and I learned from them both good and bad. They did the best they can as parents. Sometimes they did good, really good. When they were good, they were really good. Sometimes they messed up. And so I just had to learn to imitate the good things that they did. And the bad things that they did, just throw it out. I believe the crisis of fatherhood in the family contributes to the crisis in the faith today. God is a spirit, not a male or a female. The Bible presents God in the image of the Father, as Jesus taught us in that prayer, Our Father. But whenever we experience a good, loving father missing in our life, then the youth will develop a lack of trust in the father figure, even in God the Father. Whenever the youth experience a good father figure, who showers them with love, with understanding, who guides them, then the children tend to believe a loving, good God who is father to the children he brought to life. I'm going to tell you the story of a father and a husband who has been honored by the church in the year 2001. He and his wife became the first blessed couple in the Catholic faith. His name is Luigi Quattrocci and his wife Maria. They lived in Italy in the early 1900s. Every day, they would schedule to attend Mass, to receive Holy Communion. Every evening they prayed the Rosary together. Luigi had his family consecrated to the Sacred Heart of Jesus, and they had that image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus placed on the mantle in their dining room. They kept Holy Hour on the eve of the first Friday of the month. And they took time, when they had the time, to go to weekend retreats. Luigi and Maria also opened their homes as safe haven to refugees during World War II. Eventually, they had children, the first
was a son, Filippo, who became a diocesan priest. Then the other children were born. Next one was Stefania, who became a Benedictine nun. And then the third, Cesare, he became a Trappist monk, a Cistercian monk. And then when Maria was expecting their fourth child, it was a difficult pregnancy. The OBGYN advised abortion so that Maria can save her own life. But Luigi and Maria refused to have that abortion, although the chances of Maria's survival was only 5%. Maria and Luigi put their whole trust in God's providence. And God responded with a daughter. Her name, Enrichetta. She and her mother were safe after she was born. And so, around the year 2000, the four children recalled that their parents led a simple life. Their family life was never dull. They always had time for prayer, for sports. They spent holidays by the sea, by the mountains in Italy. And that tells us that Luigi, Maria, and their four children, being led by this man, Luigi, a man who experienced real problems during the 50 plus years of marriage. But Luigi and Maria, they faced their difficulties trusting God. After they died, there was a man with a severe disorder of his circulatory system. While he was praying to Luigi and Maria, he was healed. The young man is now in his 50s, a surgeon in Milan, Italy. And with this miracle, both Luigi and Maria were elevated by the Pope back then as blessed Luigi and Maria. They became the first married couple to be beatified together. And usually, you know, the feast days of the saints and the blessed are on the day of their death. But since the two died at different dates, Pope John Paul II decided to place the feast day on the anniversary date of their marriage, November 25. With their beatification, the Church recognized that this sacrament of marriage is also a valid pathway towards holiness. And so as we prepare this afternoon to receive the Blessed Sacrament, let us pray for all fathers in the past, in the present, in the future, that they may be more faithful to their duties, to God, and to their family. We pray that God would give all fathers the moral strength and the wisdom they need to become good role models so that their children will always look up to their father. And let us pray for the children who have lost their fathers through divorce or death or negligence. May God show himself as the father to these children in such a tangible way that the emptiness in their heart left by their negligent, absent father will be healed with the love of God, who is the Heavenly Father of us all. At this time, I ask all fathers to please stand. I'm going to give you a blessing, okay? God our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these men that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Now, everybody else, please stand. And together we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead. With trust in our merciful God, we offer these prayers, making our response, Lord, hear our prayer.
That our Holy Mother Church may continue to receive the help of Christ in using her prophetic voice, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all people may come to know that Jesus is Lord of heaven and earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That fathers may know of our gratefulness for their strength and love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the seeds of faith planted in our hearts at baptism may continue to flourish and grow towards spiritual maturity, let us pray to the Lord. That the souls of the faithful departed may find eternal peace in God's presence, let us pray to the Lord. That the Lord may hear the needs in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
And together let us ask the angels and the saints to help us to be good to all fathers, our
Thy
kingdom come. I was going to ask you to pray to St. Michael, but you prayed the Our Father instead. Well, as I was saying, let us pray for we would be more respectful to our fathers and to all fathers so that they won't give up on us, they won't lose hope. You know, life is hard, right? Yes? Okay, so we have to encourage even the fathers, okay? St. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray.
And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Lord our God, hear the prayers of your people and answer them in your goodness, for we pray them in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Our hymn for the preparation of the gifts can be found at number 201 in the hymnal, Beautiful Savior, number 201.
Please stand and pray as brothers and sisters that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewal with your sacraments. Grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen estate, and by his suffering he canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of the angels and the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, and from the world's beginning, you are ceaselessly at work so that the human race may become holy, just as you yourself are holy. Look, we pray, upon your people's offerings and pour out upon them the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, in whom we too are your sons and daughters. Indeed, though we once were lost and could not approach you, you loved us with the greatest love. For your Son, who alone is just, handed himself over to death and did not disdain to be nailed for our sake to the wood of the cross. But before his arms were outstretched between heaven and earth to become the lasting sign of your covenant, he decided to celebrate the Passover with his disciples. As he ate with them, he took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, knowing that he was about to reconcile all things in himself, through his blood to be shed on the cross, he took the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine. And once more giving you thanks, he handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of your Son, Jesus Christ, who is our Passover and our surest peace, we celebrate his death and resurrection from the dead. And looking forward to his blessed coming, we offer to you, who are our faithful and merciful God, this sacrificial victim who reconciles to you the human race. Look kindly, most compassionate Father, on those you unite to yourself by the sacrifice of your Son, and grant that by the power of the Holy Spirit, as they partake of this one bread and one chalice, they may be gathered into one body in Christ, who heals every division. Be pleased to keep us always in communion of mind and heart, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop. Help us to work together for the coming of your kingdom until the hour when we stand before you, saints among the saints, in the halls of heaven, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her blessed spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint Ignatius, and all the saints, and with our deceased brothers and sisters, whom we humbly commend to your mercy. Then, freed at last from the wound of corruption and made fully into a new creation, we shall sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives for all eternity. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Together, let us place all the people in the world into the hands of God. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. For those who didn't receive communion and the people at home who are watching us, we pray the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. We have a few announcements. The poor boxes this weekend are designated for our local needy. We will appreciate your generosity. The Knights of Columbus are in the narthex selling and collecting tickets for their shrimp feast raffle. This is your last chance. The drawing is this afternoon. And then next week is our turn to supply casserole for beans and bread. If you'd like to help, please pick up a pan and a recipe in the narthex and return the frozen casserole next weekend. Please stand and let us pray. First of all, turn around and wave to the people at home, and also to Monsignor. Monsignor is probably watching us. He's the father of the parish. Give him a big kiss. Mwah. Let us pray. As this reception of your Holy Communion, O Lord, foreshadows the union of the faithful in you, so may it bring about unity in your church through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn is number 506, Faith of Our Fathers, number 506.